السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
وعليكم السلام.
Our topic today is Tawbah. And this chapter is very important. Tawbah is extremely important. And when the ulama before, they used to wrote a book and they talk in that book about the imam, their fate. The first chapter they start with, chapter of Tawbah. And the Tawbah in the dictionary Arabic meaning means return. For example, you drive, suddenly you find out that you are taking the wrong track. The moment that you know that you are on the wrong way, what you will do? You will start making, but before you make a return, you slow the speed. You start slow the speed and then you make a U-turn. Tawbah is the U-turn. And now, my dear brothers, this Tawbah is, ulama, they said it's fard ayn on every Muslim. Every Muslim, male or female, it's fard. You cannot say it's okay. You cannot sneak with Allah. You cannot hide from Allah. Everyone, no matter who he is, king, from the king till the small servant, girl, boys, I mean adult, anyone, he must make tawbah from all the sins. Allah says in Quran, وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا, all of you. So it's a call from Allah to us to make tawbah. Or else, my dear brothers, our iman will have no sense. Will have no value in the eyes of Allah. Rasulullah, when he says in the hadith, لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو مؤمن ولا يسرق السارق حين يسرق وهو مؤمن. The man who commits zina, he's not a mu'min. And the man who steal, he's not mu'min. It means any Muslim who commits major sin, he's not mu'min. And Abdullah ibn Saud explained this hadith. He says, the iman in his heart, while he starts committing the sin, is removed from the heart and is put over his head. The moment he makes tawbah, that iman returns. Now many people think, but the person who committing major sin, make sin on adultery or steal, he still believe that there is no God but Allah. Sahih wa lillah. How come Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La yu'min. La yizni zani hin izni wa huwa mu'min. Why Rasulullah negate the iman from him? Ulama, they said in the tafsir of this hadith, they said the iman that will save him at the deathbed, the iman that will save him from punishment. Or else, my dear brother, many Muslims, when they will die, they will go to Jahannam. When Jibreel come to Rasulullah to mention him the darak, the levels of Jahannam, from the sa'ir, which is the last below level, to the highest level, he mentioned the mushrikeen, the sabi'a, etc. But when he reached to the seventh level, he was quiet. So Rasulullah told him, who will be on the seventh level? So Jibreel told him, Ahlul kaba'iri min ummatika ya Rasulullah. So it has been reported that Rasulullah 3 days, he cried excessively by the mercy, his heart is full of mercy for these members of his ummah that believe that Allah is one and that believe Muhammad is Rasulullah, still they will be punished in Jahannam. So what this iman did for them? It's not an iman enough to save them from Jahannam. And that's why Rasulullah said, لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو يؤمن. It means, once you reach the level of iman that you repent, that is the iman that's called salvation. Imam al-Ghazali, when he mentioned, he has chapter, he says, المهلكات والمنجيات. المهلكات, it means, means that lead you to destruction. And المنجيات means that lead you to salvation. The first chapter on the munjiyat is the tawbah. Tawbah lead you to salvation. Once you don't make tawbah, you are in big danger. You are in big danger. You understand? Like for example me. I want to buy, for example, a heater for my wife and children. Say for example, I live in the town. And I waste the money, but I have only half price.
So I expect my father and my parents, my family will die by cold. So I expect, I said, no problem. The owner of the store is so generous. I'll give him half price, he will give me the heater. You understand? So this is the example of someone who insists in the major sin, and he says, Allah is Ghafur Rahim, if I die, he will forgive me. So maybe the person is so generous, but he says, I can't. I don't have enough money. And your family will be in destruction. So the tawbah, my dear brothers, tawbah means to return. And all of us has to return to Allah. If we don't return to Allah, we are called lost. Like a horse. A horse in the farm of the owner. The servant clean him, comb his hair, feed him on time, maintain him. But once he jumped from the fence and ran away, he suffers. He has no food, he lives in the jungle, he lives the life of fear. Once he returned and he entered back to the owner's place, farm, then the farmer, the owner hugged him and he take care of him. This is the example of someone who is involved in the sin. He's like that lost horse in the jungle. He faced all kind of calamities. And the father, my dear brother, also, when he tells to his son, study, study, and he does not listen. So he keep playing. He keep fooling his father. He keep showing to his father that he study. Once he leave, he go and play. So what time the father will recognize the result is on when they show the test. So when the test has been mailed to the father, and he saw that son fail, what the father did to his son? He gave him punishment. He gave him punishment. So my dear brothers, the scholar, they said, At-tawbatu wajibatu min kulli dhanb. Any sins anyone commit, he must make tawbah on it. What time? As soon as possible. As soon as possible. Why? Because none of us has guaranteed to live tomorrow. None of us. Many people, they are in intensive care. And they are in the bed for over 20 years. And healthy young boys sleep, never wake up. Or he dies suddenly. One brother from the Jama'at told me, in Medina Masjid, a young boy, he was talking, and he came out from the Masjid holding the phone, talking on the driveway. He doesn't know that someone. An old man, he has maybe weak sight or something, or he was also talking, and he hit him from the back, he fell dead right away. A young boy. Death comes suddenly, and you go with this pain and sorrows forever and ever. يقول جاء في الأثر أكثر صياح أهل النار من التسويف. Majority of the shout and pain of the people in Jahannam for the word of I'll do that later. تسويف. Sawfa. Sawfa, it means I will. And it has been reported by one Sahabi that Sawfa, I will, is one of the soldiers of Shaitan. I will repent. No problem, I will do it in 1 year, 2 years. And he will keep dragging you till death comes suddenly. And you go with this sorrow. This sorrow will be with you forever. And that's why scholars, they said, select between the fire of regret or the fire of punishment. You have to choose. If you have this regret and pain, and you want to make tawbah sincerely to please Allah, you don't commit, you don't avoid the make tawbah from the adultery because you are afraid from AIDS, or you steal because you are afraid from the 6 years in the jail. This is not ikhlas. The sin has to have tawbah to please Allah. You do it by the fear of Allah, you make sincere tawbah. So the condition, my dear brother, of tawbah ulama, they said, first of all, is the ilm, the knowledge. Now, I will open a bracket. What does it mean, knowledge? Sometimes some people commit sin and they don't know that they are commit sin. Or they said it's okay. Now, my dear brothers, anything in the deen, especially I'm talking deen, because we have to filter our deen from tradition, from opinions of normal people, from your own thinking. Your deen has to be filtered, has to be pure, has to be authentic, like fake honey or true honey. Like this, your deen has to be true.
Don't fool yourself. If you fool, you cannot fool me. You fool yourself. Like interest, adultery, everybody brought a new names, modified the names. The enemy of Islam, what they do in order to make you insist in the sin? They will just brought a new name. When you look to a woman, they said you make tafakkur in the qudra of Allah. This is kind of the tazanduq. You make interest, the interest, they call it fa'ida. Fa'ida in Arabic means it benefits. They call interest benefits. You understand? So all the sins, the knowledge means you have to be truthful to yourself. And you have to know what are the sins. What are the sins? And don't be in it, fall in the trap of, we are in Canada, this is 2015. You cannot do that. Allah, the creator of the universe, He sent Rasulullah with a message that is applicable anytime, anywhere, till the day of judgment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah said, لِيَحْيَا مَنْ حَيَّ عَلَى بَيِّنَا وَيَمُوتَ مَنْ مَاتَ عَلَى بَيِّنَا. So the person who lives, he lives with the clear way. The way of Islam that shows the halal and haram. And whosoever die, he die on a clear way. There is no excuse. There is no escape. يقول الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الصحابة in the last way advice تركتكم على المحجة البيضاء. I left you, he said to the Sahaba, I left you on a clear, flat, easy way. The night of it, like the day, it means, what does it mean night like a day? It means it's clear. Even at night, if you are in any confusion, you know what you will do. You understand? You know what you will do. It means the Islam is clear. لا يزيغ عنها. Whosoever left that way, إلا هالك, he'll put himself into destruction. He put himself into destruction. So the first condition of Tawbah is the knowledge. Knowledge, it's the awareness. You know that you are taking the wrong track. Like driving the car. I want to go to Montreal. Suddenly I'm thinking too much about the bills. Nowadays everybody think about the bills and about the credit, etc. And I took the QW East, West. And while I'm close to the airport, I find out that I am taking the wrong track. That knowledge that I'm taking the wrong track, we have to stop in it now. When somebody insists on that sin, and he is aware, shaitan attack. What he's saying? He says it's okay. The mufti say, and he bring you excuse. Now, shaitan attack. Now, if you are, Allah knows your heart. If you put the love of this dunya over the love of Allah, the love of dunya over the love of akhirah, to satisfy your own nafs over pleasing Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and follow his way, then you open the gate to shaitan. Shaitan, my dear brothers, does not attack you and enter in your heart. Shaitan, he only whisper. And that's why they call it waswasa. Was, what does it mean, was, in Arabic? Was. Was is the voice of the earring that the woman put. In the Arab of the time of Rasulullah, the earring used to be a little bit longer. So whenever she walked, the earring keep making a noise. The noise of this metal called was. When it keep making noise, it's called waswas. So the shaitan waswas, it means he come and whisper. He just whisper. And Allah clearly showed us in the Quran. He says, وَمَا كَانَ لِعَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. I have no proof in any way, in any things I told you. إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ. I have just invited you to the sin. فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. You answer my call. You open the door. For example, somebody knock your door. You see from the mirror, you find the thieves. A man that is holding knife and he's in rage and he looks like a gangster. You open for him the door? No, even if you forget to put the chain lock, you add the chain lock. And you tell everybody, keep quiet. After a while, when nobody open, and he hear, for example, noise, he will see people are there, he will look, go. Shaitan is like this, he knock. He keep knocking, he whisper. If your heart is sick, if you love the sin, then you open for him the gate, and you become friend of shaitan. And this is what Allah said in the Quran, لا تتخذوا أفتتخذونه ودريته
أولياء من دوني وهم لكم عدو بئس للظالمين بدلا. You choose Shaitan over me, you choose Shaitan as a wali over me, and he is leading you to Jahannam. بئس للظالمين بدلا. What a worse exchange you have making that lead you to Jahannam. Exchanging Allah's rahmah, hidayah, protection over the selection of to be friend with Shaitan. So that's why my dear brothers, scholar, they said, Shaitan, he whisper, you open for him the door. So sometimes when you go on the wrong track and the awareness come and you say, no, I'm in the wrong way. This is wrong. I'm wasting my gas, I'm wasting my time, and I'm going on the wrong track. There is no benefit. Then the Shaitan come and attack and say, it's okay. You are still young. You can go for Hajj. And you are in Canada, everybody is like you. You are on the same boat. So many excuses. Now if you say, no, La ilaha illallah, Allah is my provider. Allah is my protection. Allah is the one who sustain me. You have this tawakkul. This is called tawakkul. What does it mean, tawakkul? Tawakkul is you trust Allah, you don't trust your degree, you don't trust your company, you don't trust a human being, you trust Allah, but you do the sabab that pleases Allah. So that's why, my dear brother, it is very important for the tawbah to have the ilm. Ilm, it means you know what are you doing, whether it is wrong or right. And Sahaba, they used to ask Rasulullah about everything they are doing. They ask Rasulullah. So you have to ask anything that is confused to you, ask. Don't live the life of tradition, life of your tribe, life of your own people. And he says, I find my people doing like this, I am doing. Maybe they are doing shirk, maybe they are doing something wrong. Maybe ulama, they said, this is sin, this is Rasulullah, never do. Maybe you are doing bid'ah. This is exactly what the mushrikeen said to Rasulullah. Inna wajadna aba'ana ala ummati. Wa inna ala atarihi muqtadun. We find our father doing this, and we are following their steps. So, the first condition of tawbah is the knowledge. Number two, once you are aware that what you are doing wrong, what you have to do? You have to do tawbah. You have to regret. And Rasulullah say, "An-nadamu tawbah." Why? Because one of the biggest pillars of the tawbah is the regret. Someone who regret is where? What is the place of the regret? His heart. That means that you are sincerely feeling the pain about what you are doing. You did not like it, you hate it. So that means that you are truthful. Once you regret in your heart what you did, that means you know that this is wrong, and you regret what you were doing, and now you intend, the irada is built to stop doing it. Those are the conditions of tawbah. Now, my dear brothers, if the sin between you and Allah, those are the three conditions of tawbah. Al-nadam, al-iqla', al-azm al-ya'ud. If someone took the money of people or the trust of people, scholar, they said there is two conditions. If these people are easy to find, or if these people you cannot find, or they are dead. Now, if the people they are easy to find, you have to right away return back their trust. You cannot borrow money from someone, $10,000, and keep it in your bank and cry before Allah, say, Allah, I regret, and I make tawbah, and you enjoy this money. No. You have to return back the money. That is the condition number four. Because that's called حقوق العباد, the right of others. Now, scholar, they said, if you don't find the person, you have to look for him. You have to look for him almost a year or over a year. You do all the asbab till you are hopeless from finding him. So what you do with this money? Some scholar, this is opinion of ulama. They said that money, 10,000, that you took from the person and you seek his... You look for him, you could not find him. Make sadaqah on his behalf with that money. Say, oh Allah, I took this money from this man, and now I make tawbah. And this money is with me. Oh Allah, I make you aware that I make intention that I'm going to give charity on his behalf. So this will reach him. At least you do this to not keep with you the money. You understand? It is very important. Now, scholar, my dear brother, they said, if someone make tawbah from interest, For example, I used to borrow people with the interest. And I build up, for example, $50,000. All of it is interest. All of it is interest. When I make tawbah, I should not keep this money of interest. Allah says in Quran, فَإِن تُبْتُمْ فَلَكُمْ رُؤُوسُ أَمْوَالِكُمْ لَا تَظْلِمُونَ تُظْلَمُونَ وَلَا تَظْلِمُونَ وَلَا تُظْلَمُونَ. What does it mean, رأس المال? What does it mean, رأس المال? رأس المال is the money that you start the business with on the first hand. So for example, I start business of interest with 10,000 and I make 60,000. Allah says in Quran, فَإِن تُبْتُمْ فَلَكُمْ رُؤُوسُ أَمْوَالِكُمْ. If you make tawbah, keep رأس المال. And I hear a beautiful story about this. It's ajeeb, subhanAllah. One man in Belgium, he used to have a bar selling wine. And he makes so much money. So some people come to him at night, pious people, and they give him da'wah. And he make tawbah. When he make tawbah, he send a letter to Saudi. The question, the fatwa is this. He says, I make tawbah and I stop. Nobody is in my bar now. I lock it. But if I sell the bar and the money in the bank, I will have such and money. So can you tell me, I make tawbah, what shall I do? So the answer come from Alim. He says, how much money you had before you start this wine and bar? So he answered him back. He gave them roughly the amount. He says, sell everything, give away all in charity and you have no reward, and keep only the money that you have the business with. And he keeps, subhanAllah, about $2,000 or $3,000, and he bought, shariu is the hot dog car, yes. He bought a hot dog car place, and he sell fish in the port of a small city in Belgium. And subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put so much barakah in his life. He has three kids, they become hafid of the Quran. His wife is full parda, and he is very pious. Why? Because he overpowered his desire. The love of dunya come out from his heart. He said, this is all garbage. My main thing is my Allah. I'm going to die. Everybody, innaka mayitun, wa innahum mayitun. وَمَا لِجَعَلْنَا لِأَحَدٍ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ الْخُلْدَ أَفَإِنْ مِتَّ فَهُمُ الْخَالِدُونَ. Who is enjoying this dunya? Whosoever think that this dunya is paradise, he is fooling himself. Small disease can happen to you, you are gone, finish. One young boy, he told the story of his tawbah. He says, I used to go with women. And he says, one woman I used to go with her, commit with her, fahisha, and she keep his phone number. Because he have money, whenever he wants to do fahisha, give her money, do fahisha with her. He says, after a while, that woman, he call her, stop calling, and the police call him one day. So when he come to the police station, they ask him his name, they said, yes, what do you want? They told him, we find your name on a cell phone of a woman that is in the hospital now, and it's under the protection of the police. Your name is this? He says, yes. He says, this woman has AIDS, and she commit the zina with many people. Now we are trying to reach out to these people because they will have the disease. So he says, I negate to them. I tell them, no, I never did anything with her. I just have, meeting her somewhere and give her my name, number, in case she needs my help. So the police released him. And he says, I did not sleep that night because I said to myself, I have this disease now. So he says he went to the hospital specialized for this kind of treatment, and they do check. He says, when I ask, he says, I want to know right now whether I have AIDS or not. They tell him, it doesn't work out this way. You have to give us your blood sample, you have to go through treatment, and you have to wait 10 days so you can get the result. He says, I can give any money, make it express, 2-3 days. They said, no, 10 days. So he says, that 10 days, I never slept. I was crying at night, fasting the day. Look, subhanAllah, the nature of the Adami. When he has money, healthy, young, he is like a crazy. Once the calamity before, he become the weakest human being on earth. The weakest creation. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ خُلِقَ هَلُوعًا إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ هَلُوعًا وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ هَلُوعًا وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جزوع. So My dear brothers, this young boy, he says, I call on the seventh day. So the secretary gets angry at him, tell him, I told you come in 10 days, why you call now? So he hung up the phone on him. On the 10 days, he says, my feet cannot carry me. He says, I'm going to the place as if I'm going to the death bed, to the death punishment, to die. So he says, I don't know how I drive and how I climb those stairs. Every step on the stairs, as if I carry mountains. And he worshiped, because imagine, my dear brothers, a disease that has no cure, what does it mean? Slow death, slow death. May Allah save us and save all the Muslims. So he says, when he reached and there was a waiting list, they told him wait, and when his turn come, the doctor was asking him, taking his information, looking, turning the page, and he says, I feel like I am in the day of judgment. And Allah is giving the order to go to Jannah or Jahannam. This is how he was scared. And then he says, congratulations, you have no AIDS. He says, I fall and make sajda to Allah, and from that day, I make tawbah. So scholar, they said, my dear brothers, we don't wait, because my dear brothers, tawbah will not be accepted in many occasions. Be careful. One of the occasions is when the deathbed, when the soul reached the neck. This is the tawbah of Fir'aun. Fir'aun said, la ilaha illallah, in the deathbed. He said, la ilaha illallah. He said, amantu annahu la ilaha illa alladhi amanat bihi banu Israel. What is this? This is tawheed, la ilaha illallah. He said it in the deathbed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he told him, al ana, now. So Allah rejected him. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allahu yaqbalu tawbat al-abd ma lam yugharghir. Al-gharghara is a noise that comes from the throat when the soul reached this place. So Allah will not, Allah will reject your tawbah. Second time when the tawbah will be rejected is when the sun come out from the west. When the sun rays, Allah said in the Quran, Allah Rasulullah say, لا تنقطع الهجرة حتى تنقطع التوبة ولا تنقطع التوبة حتى تطلع الشمس من مغربها. I finish by one day, one thing that scholars, they said, my dear brothers, they said, ulama, they said, my dear brothers, if you someone make tawbah from a major sin and he insists on other major sin, someone who commits adultery and he eat interest and he drink wine, if he decide to stop drinking wine, not because the doctor will tell him that you have cirrhosis of liver or you have liver cancer because of this wine, you have to stop it, and he stop it, this tawbah is not accepted. There is no ikhlas in it. You have to do tawbah to please Allah only. So if he make tawbah from the wine, scholar, they said, Allah will accept the tawbah of that wine. But if he die, insist on the interest or committing other sin, he will be punished according to that sin. Or he will be forgiven. This is our aqidah, by the way, my dear brother. I open bracket. If somebody die committing major sin, you still have to do salat al-janazah on him. And nobody should talk bad about him because you don't know. Maybe Allah will have mercy on him. Ulama, they said he is under the mashi'at. And Rasulullah said this in the bay'ah of Muhajirin and Ansar. He says, whosoever commits sin, and we know about it, we will establish hadd on him. Hadd is the punishment of the dunya. And whosoever commits this, and he hide it, and he insists on it, he is under the will of Allah. If he wants, he will punish him. And if he wills, he will forgive him. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله. السلام عليكم.